Hey everyone, this is Paul from BASSBOSS, and in this video what I'm going to be doing is showing you how to update the firmware of your Mark III BASSBOSS speakers so you can get the maximum performance out of them. So there's going to be two things you're going to need. You're going to need the BASSBOSS ControlBASS software, which I'm going to launch right now, and you're also going to need a firmware update file. We're going to provide those online so you can download the latest version. So I've downloaded this one to the BASSBOSS update folder. So the one I need to update is this DV12 Mark III R2. So in this control center window, what I'm going to do is click on this green arrow to open up the speaker page. This is what we're going to see. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on File and I'm going to click on Load Factory Settings. This is going to allow me to specify the update file, the firmware update file that we're going to flash onto the DSP. So Load Factory Settings, it's going to basically say, look, all the settings and presets are going to be updated. So we're going to have new factory presets. The limiter settings are likely going to be updated and everything. So just don't disconnect the unit or power it off during the process. And then when it's over, what we're going to want to do is probably power cycle it. So I'm going to click OK. I'm going to go under downloads and I'm going to just go ahead and choose that .ffi file that I have that's going to be the latest version. So this is R3 and I'm currently running R2. So I'm going to click open or OK and it's going to go ahead and start the process. It'll initialize, wipe the DSP and then upload the new firmware with all the new presets on it. Now, the speaker may make a little bit of noise during the process. Don't worry, that's totally normal and just basically be ready to power cycle it when it's done. That way, can have it up to the latest version and make sure your speakers are hitting the hardest. Awesome. So now it's complete. I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to go ahead and close this window and it's going to basically be reconnecting and you'll now see the latest version of the firmware displayed here. So they're going to reconnect. And at this point, once again, this is a good idea once this reconnects to just power cycle the unit just to make sure it's, you know, everything gets written correctly. There it is. This is the version that we have. We kind of see its IP address and we can ensure that it got updated by going under help and about, and you will actually see that the firmware version has now been updated. So hope you found this helpful and we definitely recommend keeping your speakers up to date so that they sound the best and have the best performance. Have a good one.